मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे ऑन फ्राइडे 17th आई एम स्टार्टिंग द नेक्स्ट पोर्शन, दैट इज़ पार्ट 9 ऑफ द लेसन नंबर 2 सॉल्यूशन. आई कुडंट टेक इन द लेक्चर ऑन वेडनेसडे एंड थर्सडे ड्यू टू सम रीजंस. सो टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग अगेन लेसन नंबर 2 सॉल्यूशन पार्ट 9. Today on page number 47 up to page number 47, here after the plot 2.5, Raoult's law, obey vapor pressure wala, wo humne we did only. So today we are starting from page number 47, 2.51, ideal and non-ideal solution. What are called ideal solutions and non-ideal solutions? We are starting from 2.5. Already we studied liquid and gas and liquid and solid. Now we are starting our liquid-liquid solutions. They are classified into ideal and non-ideal solutions on basis of Raoult's law. Okay. So what are ideal and non-ideal solution? 2.5.1. The solutions which obey Raoult's law over the entire range of concentration are known as ideal solutions. They have two other important properties. The enthalpy of mixing of pure component to form solution is zero, and the volume of mixing is also zero. That is delta mix H is equal to zero. Delta maximum mixture volume is 2.21 xm. Enthalpy and volume is zero. How I can explain? See, this means that no heat is absorbed or evolved when the components are mixed. Also, the volume of solutions should be equal to the sum of volumes of two components. Now I will explain you. Okay, when we are going to mix water and alcohol, okay, then no heat is evolved or no heat is absorbed, and the volume is also equal. How if I am taking 10 ml of water and 10 ml of ethanol, then the volume should be equal to the volume of the both the solutions. So volume is also not going to increase, it is zero. Enthalpy is also zero and volume is also zero. This means no exothermic, no endothermic. And what are the ideal solutions? Okay, ideal solutions means enthalpy is zero and volume is zero. Means if I am taking 10 ml, then they will be 20 ml. And no heat is evolved or absorbed. Now, at molecular level, ideal behavior explained by two components. Suppose I am taking solvent A and solute B. Now in pure components, whether one liquid is solvent and other liquid is solute, the intermolecular interaction will be of type AA. Solvent, if solvent A, then their only interaction will be in their molecules only. And BB, solute, if solute is there, then they are having same interaction of the same molecules. Whereas in binary solution when we are mixing solute and solvent, in addition of these two interaction, other AB type solvent and solute, see, first separate, then they are going to mix, then they are having AB type of interaction will be also present. Now if the intermolecular attraction forces between AA and BB are nearly equal to these between AB, this leads to formation of ideal solution. Means the intermolecular attraction forces which are forming between AA and BB, it leads to the equal to the AB type, then they will form the ideal solution. Now perfectly ideal solution is rare, but some solutions are nearly ideal in behavior. For example, I am saying solution of normal hexane, solution of normal heptane, bromoethane, chlorobenzene, benzene, toluene, etc. are in this category. Okay, means when you will study the organic compounds, no, in the organic chemistry, already you studied in the 11th also you are knowing hexane kya hai, are you knowing? No. Then benzene you are knowing, toluene component group is CH3, bromomethane. Then these compounds are following ideal behavior. Now our next topic is non-ideal solution, 2.5 to non-ideal solution. What are non-ideal solutions? Now when a solution does not obey Raoult's law over the entire range of concentration, then it is called non-ideal solution. When it follows, then ideal. When it doesn't follows, then non-ideal. Now what is there in that? The vapor pressure of such a solution is either high or lower than the predicted by Raoult's law, which we followed from the equation 2.16. Okay, maybe it is higher or maybe it is lower. Now if it is higher, the solution exhibits positive deviation, and if it is lower, then it exhibits negative deviation from the Raoult's law. Now the plot of Vp as a fraction of mole fraction for such a solutions are shown in figure 2.6. I am showing you on page number 48 of the textbook. You can see here, you can see the vapor pressure of two component system as a mixture of components for a solution that is shows positive deviation from Raoult's law and a negative deviation. You can see vapor pressure of a solution normally, and it goes up or it goes lower. I will explain. See, suppose in water, now what is that? The plot of vapor pressure are as a mole fraction are for such a solution are shown in figure 2.6. Now what is the cause? The cause for these deviations, that is in the nature of intermolecular are at the molecular level. Interaction between molecular level. The cause for these deviations lie in the nature of interaction at the molecular level. Now in case of the deviation, in case of positive deviation from Raoult's law, AB interactions are weaker than those between AA and BB. Okay, these are pure solvent, and this force when combining binary solutions, AB interactions are weaker. This means that in such solutions, molecules A or B will find it easier to escape than in pure state. This will increase the Vp and results into the positive deviation. So this is positive deviation. Okay, in A, positive deviation, it goes higher. Now the increase, this will increase the Vp and results into the positive deviation. Example, mixture of ethanol and acetone. And other examples are given here on this page. You can see other examples are also there. So many examples are there. Now again, in case of negative deviation from Raoult law, the intermolecular attracting forces between AA and BB are weaker than those of between AB. So this leads to decrease in Vp, results in negative deviation. Example, phenol and aniline. This decrease the escaping tendency of molecules for each component, and consequently the Vp decrease, resulting in negative deviation from Raoult's law. Figure 2.6b, you can see decrease, okay, going down. You can see for this pure and going down, and this going up. This is positive and this is negative. Okay, have you followed? Now we are going to our next topic, that is, what are azeotropes? Some liquids on mixing from azeotropes, which are binary mixture having the same composition in liquid and pure phase, and boil at a constant temperature. In such case, it is not possible to separate the components by fractional distillation. There are two types of azeotropes called azeotropes: minimum boiling azeotrope, maximum boiling azeotrope. Now I will explain you. Already in 10th you did Already in 10th, you did the separation of petroleum destructive distillation. Okay? In that, आप क्या करते थे? What you were doing? You were doing fractional distillation. So, at different boiling temperatures, kerosene was coming, diesel was coming, petrol was coming. At last, you were getting naphthalene. So, each and every boiling point, you were getting separate components. Now, the solution, there are azeotropes, minimum boiling azeotropes, maximum boiling azeotropes. The solution which show a large positive deviation from Laud's law form minimum boiling azeotropes. At a specific components, for example, ethanol and water. The solution which show a negative deviation from Raoult's law from maximum boiling azeotropes, specific composition, example, nitric acid and water. Okay, so I taught you what are azeotropes, minimum boiling azeotrope and maximum boiling azeotropes. Up to page number 49, I taught you. So, from the page number 47, 48 and 49, I taught you up to azeotropes. So, please prepare with me.